As you mentioned that Quran is God's word, I just want to ask you, who is the creator of the God? What is the origin of God?
Well, that's a very good question. That if Quran is the word of God, who is the creator of God? Very good question. It is like someone asked me, if I ask you, brother, that your friend John, he gave birth to a child. Can you guess the child was girl or a boy? Your friend John gave birth to a child in the hospital. Can you guess was it a girl or a boy? Guess.
No.
Girl or a boy?
I can't guess.
Sorry?
I may not guess.
Try. At least 50% you'll get right.
Yeah, 50%. One half chance.
Okay, tell me.
Boy.
Boy. Brother, can a man give birth to a child?
No.
So is it a girl or a boy?
But the name can be called female.
I'm asking you, your friend John. I don't know anyone female called by John.
No, we can call. No.
Okay, suppose a friend who is a boy, is a man. He went to hospital. He gave birth to a child. Was it a girl or a boy?
Girl.
Can a man give birth to a child, sister?
No.
Brother?
No.
Now you understood. A man can't give birth to a child. So where's the question of it being girl or a boy? So by definition, God is uncreated. So question, who is the creator of God, is like I asking you a question. Your friend who's a man, he gave birth to a child, is it a girl or a boy? The question is illogical. Because by definition, a man cannot give birth to a child. So where is the question of girl or a boy? So by definition, God is uncreated. Every created thing has a creator. God does not have a creator. Therefore, my argument with the atheist, and never ever said that God has a creator. I said every created thing has a creator. But the God is uncreated. By definition, the moment I mentioned who is the creator of God, he is not God. Walam yakul lahu kufuwan ahad. So by definition, God is uncreated. Hope that answers the question.
Okay. Thank you.